Oh, who? Hey.
What was bragging?
What up, nigga? Nigga, why you all calm now, dog?
Hmm?
Why the fuck are you just like hella calm now, bro?
I'll be vibe.
Nigga, bro, you know I don't smoke, bro. I got like contact high from being around them.
For real?
Man. Yeah, man. I'm like hella tired and shit, dog. I don't smoke at all.
Like, they be smoking dumb. I don't be smoking either. Nigga, the most I'll smoke is a vape.
Man, shit. I only drink. I drink every day, which is not good for you either. But like, I figured.
Drink some wine.
Yeah, I should start drinking wine. I'll be drinking.
Cause you'll get, bro. Not only that, it's healthy for you. It gets you drunk / high. And then, bro, it's like there's no health defect.
Yeah, I might have to start fucking with wine a little bit, man. Yeah, I've been going hard with that Henny. You know my nigga is.
Get red wine. Okay, nigga, you drink one glass of red wine, bro. You set, bro. You in a good vibe for hours.
Nigga, don't kick no game to me like I'm your fans and shit, nigga. What the fuck you kicking?
Red wine, my nigga.
You are right. I gotta get some wine to really mix up in my shit, bro.
You got anxiety, fam.
Why you say that?
I can read you. I can see it.
You know, I can read something about you. I was gonna tell you this the last time, like, just me and you talk. This is my theory. I think when, and I know you have gone to therapy. I think when niggas have gone to therapy, they see things or they see shit in people differently from other people. You get me?
Mm.
Because I feel like you going through that and like kind of also picking up certain shit, you almost assume the role of a therapist sometimes when you're talking to other people. Because what's probably drawn out of you by your therapist, you could easily point out in other people.
I've been like this, though. I just can read people.
Why are you up this time, though? You don't sleep?
I'm always up.
Is she looking up hentai porn or some shit?
I should be, but no.
Bro, yo, can I get it on that vlog tomorrow, dog?
You want to get on the vlog?
Yeah, man. I want to kick some knowledge, too. You don't think I could kick some knowledge?
You can. We just have to go into a pact if that's what you want to do.
You be using certain words that be sound like a little bit too deep. A pact. Like, when niggas hear of a pact, sacrifice.
Aren't wolves in packs?
Yeah. But when you hear of a pact when it comes to humans, it feels like a lifetime agreement or a brotherhood.
If you want longevity, you know I got longevity. I got longevity, so it has to just be an agreement.
I ain't gonna lie, man. Bruh. What books you read?
I don't read currently.
Okay, what things do you study?
Myself, the world. I've just passed my own judgment. You know, that's what all authors really do. All authors. See, it's harder to read a book than it is to write it, truly.
Okay, I get all that. But there's somewhere where you have cultivated certain type of messages or even cultivating the way that you put those messages out and you've learned how to disseminate it in a way that people could digest and subscribe to. That's not, I don't believe that's natural.
It is natural.
Stop it, nigga.
It is natural. The only book I've ever read that taught me more about my mind was The Master Key. And that's when I was in jail. But it had nothing to do with my mind. My mind had already formulated this judgment, this perception. I've always perceived differently. That's why I was always the oddball.
Hey, oh, by the way, you're on my stream. I don't know if you know.
Right now?
Yeah, nigga. You probably don't know. There's a headset. When I have this on, I'm usually on stream.
Damn, nigga, why you ain't let me know?
You ain't saying nothing crazy. But no, what I was going to say is that, yo, shit, you were, like, super turnt earlier. Now you're just, like, in a zen mode, kicking, like, you know what I mean, on some, look like you're trying to have a deep conversation and shit.
Because my little cousin was around earlier, so I'd just be trying to make my little cousin happy. I'd be trying to entertain him.
Yo, what was that conversation you had with Kodak? How was
Which
that?
one?
Well, I don't know how many times you guys talked, but he put up a conversation and you were trying to tell him to be safe. You're like, yo, listen, watch the people around you and watch your surroundings.
I felt I'm a very aware person, and I felt energy formulating towards Kodak that he didn't need, well, that he didn't want or need formulating against him. I won't put it into words. He's very ignorant to certain things, but it's because he wants to be. You know what I'm saying? He doesn't want to. Like, I don't want to speak for the next man. You feel me? But all I was being the equilibrium in that situation, just telling him, providing him the options spiritually that he needed to perceive in order to move forward or to move backwards. But that
Who
all
does that
falls
for
down
you?
on
Who does that for
me.
you?
That's the lonely part about being me. Nobody.
Somebody probably does.
No.
Parents,
Why would I
probably.
lie? I don't have to lie to you.
No, what not necessarily. I didn't say a line, but what I'm saying is that who do you often see like tries to give you that type of, hey, listen, stop doing this?
Everyone can offer support, but nobody can be my backbone. I am my backbone.
Was
And
Kodak
then
receptive? Were you receptive to that?
Kodak was very receptive. Kodak was definitely very receptive because it's a mutual respect thing, like, but it's like, regardless of anything, we gotta respect each other's minds because of who we are. You know what I'm saying? And where we are and who we are, we're the only one that has amounted to what we've amounted to. Now, it's different if I was some random nigga coming to him spitting no game at all. But look how much I've achieved. You know what I'm saying? Look how much I've achieved. Look where my mind is, and look how differently I articulate myself from him. And we grew up basically in the same place. We grew up in Broward. He in a different city, but we grew up around the same place. You feel me? So in the same context, look how I've come out and look how he's come out. We're two different people. He has different mannerisms and he has different perception. So all I did was evaluate on my perception and what the world was telling me to tell him, and he perceived that. And whether he moves in that direction or not, I respect him as a man. He's gonna be a man regardless. So,
Do you ever feel like you owe it to your fans to kind of steer them? Like, because I feel like that's what the vlogs
yes,
are.
and that's what I'm doing, and that's what I'm doing. But my main thing is, it's a difference, right? It's a difference to be wanted and needed. If I'm needed, right? If this energy is needed, because it is. We don't have many teachers. We don't have many prophets. You know what I'm saying? How it was funny because Bob Marley said something very important. How long are, it was either Bob Marley or somebody. How long are we going to sit aside and let them murder our prophets? How long are we going to sit aside? Like, you have these people that arise and come out of nowhere, and our teachers and our people that are supposed to lead and push people in the right direction with energy.
Do you
These
feel
are the
like you're a
people
teacher and a leader?
of the youth, yes. Of the youth, because they are the ones that can be molded. I have to be very careful with my message. All I want is for people to be able to be themselves, to be free-minded, to ideally understand themselves more, and to unlock that piece of their mind that gives them clarity, that gives them ground. You know what I'm saying? But in order for me to lead people in that direction, or to lead anyone in that direction, people have to show the necessity, the need that. For me, you know what I'm saying? They have to elaborate on that. They have to be willing to show me that they care about me and put that equal effort, whether it means physically going somewhere and speaking about me, or like, bro, it would mean the world to me if people would go out of their way and leave their houses physically and do whatever they could to help me. You know what I'm saying? And if everybody put in that equal amount of energy, then I could amount to what I needed to amount to really assert myself. But sometimes it's better, like, I don't be trying to, like, tell people, like, oh yeah, bro, save me. I'm not trying to tell people that, because if it's genuine, people will do it.
Yo, you're at top of the rap game, at least for, you know, I mean,
Rap game, no. I'm on top of the music game.
okay, well, but I still even have to put a caveat.
Yeah.
When it comes to your generation, because it's going to be somebody who points out like some huge megastar and be like, he's not on that level. But still, when it comes to
But
when.
here's a strange thing though. You do realize that my energy is purely mine, right?
Like, explain.
Like, my energy is purely mine. Like, you can call my label and ask them, like, how much, if they were able to do any promotion behind anything I've done, and it will be no. Like, because even when I dropped my last album, 17, all those numbers was purely off the strength of my fan base. Purely. And that amazed the fuck out of everyone because it was like, yo, like, all right, to compare it to Uzi's drop, right? Uzi's drop had plenty of interviews behind it. Uzi had a huge...
Had a rollout major, marketing budget. Yeah,
exactly. And it was all planned, pre-planned. Now, mine, that was literally me saying, yo, me talking to my fans, yo, I'm dropping it on this day and I'm going to drop it. My label had no clue. Nobody knew what the fuck I was doing.
You
just
had a distribution deal. That's important to know. You had a distribution deal.
Which I had a distribution.
They weren't going to promote your stuff. They were going to just put it out there.
They were going to just put it out and pay for it and get a percentage.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, do you think your fan base has changed? I mean, at first when it was announced that you signed, which, by the way, like, and just personally.
People haven't. My fan base has not changed. And I don't like to call it a fan base. My family has not changed. My supporters have not changed. It's what we've appropriated that has changed. It's what has become the cool shit that has changed. Some, like, look, as new artists come out, different ways waves will surface. But not all of these have longevity. Not all of these have the same purpose and meaning. Not all of these have the same raw energy. You can go to, like, all right, it's hard. It's very hard to explain, but you can see it in the energy. You can see it in the message. You can see it in everything. Like, all right. Look how many times I've got my ass kicked in the media. Look how many times. Bro, I have millions of dollars. I know plenty of people. If I really wanted someone to be harmed, I could harm them. I've stuck by my message purely not for me. It's for them. Mm-hmm. To show it's possible. It's not for me. Because if it was for me, I would have been gotten revenge. And that's always how I was. I changed myself in order to be that person for them. To be that platform for them. So when I got punched in my shit, when I went through what I went through, even when I went back to jail that last time, right? For some shit, like, and I'm not even going to evaluate on that because I'm not supposed to. I was told to, but not to by the court, so I can't say anything about that. But even when I went back to jail last time, I did want to ask
you one thing. Again, nothing about the case or anything like that. Just your mindset. When you were remanded and they put you in jail for that first day. Did you kind of, again, and I don't know if you ever looked to a higher power or not, but did you kind of look at yourself and say, yo, I fucked up? Like, yo, I'm back where I never wanted to return after I got out the last time.
No, because I know it was the universe protecting me.
What do you mean?
It was the universe protecting me. You felt because I might have been in the wrong place at the wrong time during that time.
So you didn't look at it as a bad thing. Because at that point, it was probably one of the worst times you could go in.
Why would you say that?
I mean, you're a very successful artist. You just came off dropping a very successful album. You just reportedly signed a $6 million deal, which is still...
That's all material.
Okay, but to get locked up at that point, it's like almost stopping
a reality
progress.
Check.
It's reality. So you felt it was a reality check.
Yeah.
Did you think that initially?
I was only in jail for 6 to 7 days. Initially, I questioned my entire life. I wanted to commit suicide. I started to question myself. But in question, life really starts with a question, wouldn't it? Doesn't life start with a question? Everything starts with a question. So I began to question myself. Anything that can cause you to question yourself is simply a reality check. Who am I currently? Where am I headed? What are my goals? I had realized that I had abandoned a lot of things that had made me the person I was. I had almost lost my reason. I saw myself going towards a direction that I wasn't supposed to go towards. Now, the reason I had went back to jail was a fucked up reason because it wasn't a real, real, real valid reason and I won't evaluate on it. But everything worked out how it was supposed to, wasn't it?
You know what? I'll give you credit for this. You're definitely one of the most self-aware artists I know. You know why? Because you've gone through a lot of ups and downs. Like, shoot.
Are we talking about music artists?
Are we talking about artists, period?
Because if we're talking about artists, Jim Carrey is.
Let's remove even just artists. People.
Jim Carrey.
Oh, no, but I'm trying to elaborate on you.
Okay.
You got knocked out on stage. And we've had multiple conversations since then, this is the self-awareness part, where you could say, you know what, when that happened to me, I fucked up in terms of how I handled something, or I jumped out like out the window or whatever. A lot of times people don't think that ever. You know what I mean? When something happens to you bad, you don't
because really they're not thinking for the long run.
Like, did it? Was it a process for you to feel like that though? Because at first, I could imagine, even with
the let me tell you something. I've never been a man of ego. You want to know the difference between me and artists and all these other artists? Mm-hmm. I've never been a man of ego, ever. The only ego I've had is simply feeling as if I deserved loyalty. That's the only sense of ego I've had, and that if someone was disloyal to me, that it would hurt me. And that's the only sense of ego I've had that's the only even, like, and you can't even really attach that to ego. You understand?
Hey, do you tie your need, because a lot of people like you, and even me, like, I value loyalty very high on
yes,
totem pole
yes.
with people. But I remember you put up some post, and I hope, and again, I'm not telling you what you should put in your next vlog or whatever vlog, but I hope you do elaborate on that. Like, one time you had put up a string of posts explaining why you were certain ways, and you were talking about how, like, it was kind of like your father abandoned you, and, like, you didn't grow up with a dad. You know what I mean? Is that dependency that probably came from that the reason why you value loyalty?
Let me clarify something, because I don't want my words, because I've even twisted my own words out of emotion, you know, because everything mm-hmm. is very real. So I speak on how I feel at the moment. Yeah. You understand? So abandoning the aspect like, okay, my father did what he deemed fit for his life, right? Now, that was deemed as selfish to me, because he could have taken the hard route. He could have taken the hard route just as I took the hard route, because I did take the hard route. He could have took the hard route, and he would have got a much more rewarding future. You understand? But in that, I wouldn't be me. I would be a lesser. I wouldn't be the person I exist to be today. So it was in that, him being selfish and making his own decisions for what he deemed fit for his current, for what was his current situation, that made me who I am. So I no longer try and dwell on, like, all right, look at it this way. I hated my dad, because his previous decisions had affected me. Mm-hmm. And it affected me spiritually. Because my dad was in it, like, I got locked up and was going to jail and shit. I ended up going through the same process. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Now, as far as his upbringing was far different than me. Mine was not traditional. It was almost like being thrown into a void, you know? And there's a lot about my family that people do not know. You know what I'm saying? A lot of things that my mom has been through. My family is just, like, kind of spaced apart, you know? So it's a lot to mend in itself, but I understand that I have to be that middle ground. I have to be I am the gatekeeper. So I'm the one who has to fix everything, basically.
What about resentment, right? So
I don't resent any of them. However, just as another man would hate to be under another man, which I've understood, and that's why I respect Ski so much, and that's why I want people, like, all right, people have tried to make, all right, people tried to, like, all right, the fucked up part was, I'm going to get back to the resentment, but I want to go, because this is a perfect, like, people saw, that we felt like Ski resented me to a degree because of my current status quo, but he didn't want to, like, understanding not being wanting to be seen as a sidekick, not wanting to be seen as a lesser, to be appreciated as an equal. He had to burn me and burn the bridge in order to walk his own route. And you know what I'm saying? And then that leaves space to create later on. So resentment, like, I don't resent anyone. However, I do have to walk my own path. I don't.
Hold on, though. Okay, maybe not. Resentment is a strong word.
Yeah.
Even you understanding that with Ski, didn't you feel a way?
With my father or with Ski?
No, with Ski. Like even understanding why
I felt a way to... I felt a way because I was naive. I felt a way because I was selfish. I felt a way because I did not feel the pain he felt. He is a man of ego. Now, I can't relate because I'm not a man of ego. I would not know how it felt to be, picture ego as a demon. All right? Picture.
You ain't gonna sit here and tell me that you don't have any ego.
How would I if I shaved off my fucking eyebrows and made myself ugly as a lesson? I made myself ugly as a lesson. I destroyed my sense of character as a lesson.
I don't know if that's ego or if it's like an image type of thing.
It's not an image. It was me destroying my previous self. Everyone was attached to this black and yellow hair and this attractive mugshot that made me be perceived as a beautiful person. I destroyed that person and turned into someone else that was perceived as ugly. Well, you are. But I wasn't ugly inside. I was only ugly on the outside.
So were you doing that for the people who perceived you as that, or were you doing for you?
I was doing it for everyone. I was doing it for them. I was doing it for myself because I was the next step.
So, I mean, clearly now, like, eyebrows are back or whatever, and, you know, I mean, is that process complete? Do you feel like you have destroyed that image of you that had you look a certain way?
It's slowly killing itself, because I have not been that same person. I've not, my actions have spoken. You understand? My actions have spoken for themselves. I mean, for itself. So, it's.
What do you think you've changed for the better or for the worst?
For the better. For the better. The only part is I care a lot. I care too much.
About other people or?
People that I don't even know. Like, really realize that there are literally no artists doing what I'm doing. And that carries a lot of weight. To bear everyone on my back. To take responsibility for the youth. That carries a lot of weight. So all I asked for in return was physical and mental loyalty. That carries, like, people only perceive, because I've been more playful and more, like, more comical and nice, you know what I'm saying? But understand that this is a huge, it's a blessing, it is a burden.
Yeah.
Because if I say the wrong thing, do understand that I have a million parents, teenagers, and kids responding negatively or positively. And all while doing these things, I have to be genuine. So the words have to be real. Because if I'm upset, I'm going to respond how I deem necessary when I'm upset. But it has to be real. You understand?
Of course. Listen, at one point, I remember we had a pretty heated discussion, but a respectable discussion. And that's why I respect you. Where... you know, you ain't going to call me and I'm the guy who's going to just agree with whatever you say. I'm going to challenge you and you're going to give your side. I'm going to try to give a side. And shoot, hopefully we both grow in that conversation. I remember there was a time you were very frustrated with the media. Their depiction of you, things they would choose to show, things they would not show.
I like what you just said, choose to show.
Do you feel that?
I've seen you be very genuine in what you post. You're a real one when it comes to that.
Okay.
You as well, at least when it comes to me.
Okay. Have you seen, and again, when I say the media, I am a part of the media, but I'm expanding it to every media, from the small publications to the YouTubers to the giant publications. Have you seen a change? Have you seen them be a little bit more fair in dealing with you?
They can't talk. They can't say as much, bro, because then they lose. Bro, the power. I am my own power. That's what people got to realize. You can't abuse my power. It is going to backfire. You use my energy and you think you're going to disrespect me in the process, and it will destroy you. It may take a little while, but it will destroy you. It will destroy you. Because my supporters and family are much, much, much different from everyone else's supporters and what they call them, fans. They're much different, so you get a very, very different response. And you don't need, like, okay, yeah, it's sensationalism. Sensationalism and you get that what you want for the meanwhile. But then after a while, they see that, okay, the people behind this are bad people. So the only ones that will feed on that energy are bad people. So if you like to feed on that energy, you're a weak person. You're a weak person, people like to see other people in pain because it builds their pride. It makes them feel better. Like, well, at least that's not me.
That is true. Exactly. It feels like also you're alluding to balance as well. We won't even call out particular publications, but we've seen you on, like, even your Insta Snap or whatever is it, the Insta Story. Yeah. You've kind of told your fans, like, these publications here, they're not giving me a fair shake. Please don't view me as they would portray me. Or don't fuck with them, period. You know what I mean? Have you tried to, like, reach out? Have you tried to repair?
Why the fuck would I do that? That's ingenuine.
Well,
niggas gonna hate me regardless. I'd rather them hate me.
Well, sometimes people hate what they don't know. And they hate what they don't understand.
They make me more popping when they hate me. I got so many people behind my back. They just need to make sure they're loving me properly. They need to give me the proper love. That's all it is. They need to give me to what's going to help me benefit so I can help them benefit. They need to give me the energy that I need so I can move forward.
So is it like a dependence, at least for you, on the people who do love you to keep it going? Because I remember...
I am very much so dependent on them, yes. Actually, I was wrong when I said I am my backbone. They are my backbone.
Because you know what? I remember, right? It was the first time I talked to you in a while, but you called me right after that BT Award shit happened. But it was an interesting time for you. You were getting hammered in the media. And also, I believe, like, one of your family members that got shot. And I feel like... Yeah, I think with all the criticism you were getting, it was a time that I could tell, like, you were trying to fall back a bit. You know what I mean? And, of course, you eventually, like, you know what I mean, got back on your shit. But it felt like it was the people who had to support you for that. So do you kind of just look at, like, your fan base, your family, as you call it, you look at them for support in everything you do?
Yep. No, but there's a difference between mental support and going online or getting up out of your bed and finding ways to support me however you can.
What do you mean, though? That's vague. So you want to mobilize.
My mind is a kingdom. Take pride in being a part of my mind is basically what I tell them. If I am destroyed, this energy that you crave and you desire and that you use, like, okay, if something were to happen to me, right? Like, all right, if I got shot and ended up in the hospital, and I don't have a million people outside of that hospital trying to get inside, storming inside to make sure I'm okay, I would never, ever make music ever again. Hmm. And I would abandon and become the evil person that everybody perceived me to be. And I would just be selfish like everybody else. Because then what was everything for? And I know it's possible. I know it's possible because my mind is a kingdom. Take pride in being a part of that kingdom. That energy that they feed on, this music that they use to repair their souls. Do you know how much energy I put into that? Do you know how much I sacrifice to do that?
Not too sure what happened there. Hold up.